A final consequence of Amdahl's law that we will discuss is the law of diminishing returns. Let's say that we had an original processor, which we will call Gen 1, in which our execution time can roughly be divided into a purple phase and a blue phase. Each of them takes about half the execution time. Let's say that in the Generation 2 processor, we decided to speed up the blue phase by a factor of 2. What we got now is that the purple part is not affected, and the blue part is now half as long. The overall speed up of the Gen 2 processor over Gen 1 is equal to 1 over half is not enhanced, half is sped up by a factor of 2, and we get a speed up of 133, which is a sizable speed up. Now let's say that we have a Generation 3 processor, where we again get the blue part and speed it up by a factor of 2 relative to the Gen 2 processors. Now we have that the purple part is still the same and the blue part is half of what it was. The speed up of the Gen 3 processor over a Gen 2 processor is 1 over, and now we have to be careful. The unaffected part is now 2/3 of the execution time. The affected part is only 1/3. And that part is still affected by a factor of 2. So the overall speedup is 1.2 over Gen 2. If we keep improving the blue part over the generations, eventually we will get to almost no speedup. Why? Because we are improving what amounts to less and less of the execution time. Furthermore, usually it is the case that improving something initially is not very hard. But after you exhaust the easy methods for improvement, it becomes very, very difficult to get new speedups on a thing that has been already enhanced hugely. So eventually, the solutions that will improve the purple part will be cheaper than the solutions that further improve the blue part, just because all of the easy stuff on improving the blue part we have already done. So not only do we get lower speedups by improving the blue part, it's actually becoming more difficult to do so. This is sort of a lesson to computer architects to not go overboard improving the same thing, because the things that have already improved are now a smaller percentage of the new execution time, and we need to reassess what is now the dominant part in the execution time. In other words, once you have applied one improvement, you need to reconsider what is now the new dominant part in the execution time. And definitely, when applying Amdahl's law, we need to consider what is now the fraction enhanced and the fraction unenhanced.